Hello there, this is Irv. This is a very short presentation of what I like to show what I have on my bench for the moment. Right now I'm working on a new version of Crystal Focus, and it's going to be V4 already. The main things are that I'm going to change the regular SD card, which is that size, to a micro SD card, which is this tiny little thing, to be compared with that. So hopefully it will allow me to reduce the size of the board as well, because in this case for sabers and hilt size, size does matter. So how does it work for a micro SD card? Basically nothing changes compared to an SD card, because most of the time a micro SD card is shipped with an adapter, which is nothing else than a dummy SD card. It's just a wiring adapter finally, and you have a slot in which you insert the card, and then it becomes a regular SD card to be inserted in any kind of USB SD card reader or something like that. So it's very easy to use, and the good thing also is that the technology of this card is more recent than the old SD card, so it means that the writing speed is really, really faster. So when you transfer the files into the micro SD card, it goes faster. Also, it comes in a size that is definitely much more than the regular size that I used with Crystal Focus V2 and V3. I got a pretty good deal on those 32 megabyte SD cards, and with new micro SD cards, usually it's minimum of 512 megabytes or 1 gigabyte. So it means that you can put plenty of music tracks to be played with iSaber feature, for instance. So let's get the thing started. So this is a little prototype on which I'm working for the moment. Since I don't have the new PCB, I used V3 on which I wired the new SD card holder, like in Spider, like that. But it works very well, and I've been able to test some new parts of firmware I've been working on. So here we go. I'd like to show a few things, so let's get the thing started. So it boots like usual, and then okay, this is my activator switch plier. If I try to start the thing first, okay, it doesn't work. Why? Because I've implemented the power up protection. Like press the activation button, then confirm, and then it goes up. So the board has been set up in this case to use a momentary switch to activate the luxeon. But of course it works with latching switches as well. So to power off the board, same thing. If I try to power off, it doesn't work. I have to confirm, and then it goes off. So what do we have here? Well, you can't see the luxeon because otherwise it will definitely blind the video camera. I'm sorry. So I decided to put a bit of foam on the top of that. You have actually two green luxeon 3 in there, and you have a white one here with a power extender board. So what is the goal of this setup? I wanted also to show that it's possible to wire two luxeon in parallel. Of course, they won't be working each at 1.5 amp. They are working basically at 700 milliamps each for a total current of 1.4 amp. So the idea is to show that it's possible to use several luxeon on a single core, simply because we now have the rebel luxeon that are finally a very, very, very small form factor for a powerful LED. And fortunately, now we can have several rebel LEDs on a single star PCB, just like this one I made it myself. I mean, I used a PCB and I soldered the rebuild on them using a hot air station. And this one is the RGB, which will be used for another demo, not today. So for the moment, I don't have like two greens and one white to demonstrate the thing on a single PCB, but we have exactly the same equivalent experiment here, except that it's using three stars instead of three rebel on one star. So we have two greens here, wired in parallel, so they are hitting each again 700 milliamps, and we have this one, which is a white luxeon 3, wired with a power extender. So how does it work? Well, the two greens are wired just like a normal luxeon. It's going to the luxeon driver side of the board, and it's acting just like a simple luxeon. For the power extender board, it's a sort of a remote control. It's basically like a relay, but it's not electromechanical. It's an electronic part, which is in there. So the idea is that we have this clash remote wire that is coming from the board. It's the green one, and it's going to trigger and control the little part on the power extender board, and it's going to make an electric contact inside the part, and it's going to light up the white luxeon that is here. But you have to know that the current is not regulated for that one, so it's wired just like a normal LED using a resistor to limit the current inside the luxeon. But finally, it's not a problem that the current isn't regulated, and so because it's just a flash. So the idea is that you have a secondary flash that comes out when you have a clash on the board, meaning that you have the two plates that smack together. So I'm going to demonstrate that. So power on. Oh, okay. I have to confirm. Okay. So we have the two greens that are lit light up here, and then when I make a clash, you can see the white flash. You can see also that the board is still reacting extremely fast to clashes, and the detection is really, really accurate. You have a very, very low latency between the actual clashing of the board or the vibration and the sound. So it's pretty nice. You know that we have the force sound when you combine the aux button and something equivalent to a swing. Now we have a new thing, which is the aux button combined with a clash. So the idea is that if just before touching the blade, the opponent blade during a duel, you press the aux button just a few moments before, within the lockup delay, then when you're going to smack the blades, you will get a special sound. So I don't have a really good sound for the moment. I haven't thought about it because I implemented the feature yesterday, so I decided to take something completely different so that you can hear the difference. So here we go. We have the clashes, normal clashes, okay, and then I have, oops, I have to do it again, I'm sorry, it's not very practical here. You see, you get, I press a button and you get this little sound, which is totally different just to illustrate the idea. So I press and I get a special sound. I don't press, I get clash sounds, normal clash sound. Well, it can be like a thunderstrike, it can be something a little bit extraordinary, so that you have a very, very special impact when you clash two blades. So I think that's it for today. Stay tuned on the topic called Crystal Focus V4 Roadmap on TCS's forums. Okay, bye bye.